So let us see the applications of 74LS138. There may be a requirement, students, where we need to design a single 4 to 16 decoder by using 74LS138. Now, if at all there is one such requirement, how do we need to design? It's a question. For that, first let us write the truth table for 4 to 16 decoder. Okay, so let us have the similar inputs as enable inputs. And we know that when we want to design 4 to 16 decoder, we need to have 4 inputs and 16 outputs. Right? So we do have the inputs, right? And we have 16 outputs here, right? Now, the inputs that we have will vary from 0000 to all ones, right? Now, if at all the values of G1, G2A bar, and G2B bar are of X, means if it is of any value, other than this, then we understand that the output remains high irrespective of the status of the inputs. On the other hand, if this is the condition that is there, only then the chip will be enabled. Right? And this holds good for 74LS138. The same condition has been considered here also because we are going to design the circuit by using 74LS138. So we cannot have a different condition altogether. We need to have the similar condition for enabling the integrated circuitry, right? Now, so this is the truth table we have written. Now, by looking at the truth table, we understand, see, from 0 to 7, our N3 remains, the MSB remains low, okay? And from 8 to 15, whatever has been written from 0 to 7 has been repeated. Right, the values which has been shown here is replica of whatever has been written over here, except that the MSB has become high in this case. Right, now this is a very, very important point which will help us to enable the 74038 depending on the status on this particular thing. Okay, now when all the inputs are zero, D0 will be selected and so forth. This condition remains the same just like 74LS138, okay, except that we do have 16 outputs here. Okay, now for this particular truth table, we need to design the logic diagram. Right, students, we know that whenever we are designing the logic diagram, the very first thing is we need to have the statement. We do have the statement. Now we have the truth table. Next thing that we have to do is we have to draw the K-map, and from that we have to derive the combinational logic circuit diagram. But in this particular case, it has been told that we have to use 74LS138 integrated circuit. Right? Now let us design the circuit by using 74LS138. Now, if you consider two 3-to-8 decoder students, as we have seen from the truth table, our ABC remains the same. So what can we do? We can short the ABC inputs of first IC and that of the second IC, right? Okay, so these ABCs of both the 74LS138 can be connected together, right? And here we have seen this pin could be used as a control pin, right? Now, as such is the case, we are using that as a control pin. If it is low, okay, if this is low, okay, when the pin is high, the output becomes 0, right? And this will be enabled. Okay, on the other hand, when the pin is high, this particular IC will be enabled. Right? So, when it is low, when the high MSB is low, this particular IC will be enabled and it is able to give the outputs from 0 to 7. Similarly, on the other hand, when it is high, this particular IC will be enabled and it is able to generate the output from D8 to D15, right? Now, so this is the general block diagram, students. Let us write the same diagram with respect to 74LS138. Okay, we know that 74LS138 has its own control inputs, right? So G1 could be connected to VCC through a pull-up resistor. Okay, that has been done here. Now, this N3 has been used as an enable input. Okay, now when N3 is low, that is from the outputs 0 to 7, what will happen? N3 is low, that has been connected to this particular enable pin, which happens to be active low. When N3 is low, the first sulfur LS138 will be selected. Okay, now once this is selected, based on the status on the other three inputs, the D0, one of the pins of D0 to D7 will be selected. Right, now for the inputs from 8 to 15, what will happen? N3 becomes high. Once N3 becomes high, where does this N3 has been connected to? N3 has been connected to the input G1 here. You can see here. Okay. So N3 has been connected to the G1 input of 74LS138. Okay. Once it has been connected to the G1 input of 74LS138, so from 8 to 15, that's what has been put in the truth table, written in the truth table. Okay. So the second 74LS138 will be selected. Right. Now for enabling 74LS138, we have this enable low pin. Okay. This has been connected to both the active low inputs of 74LS138. So only when this pin is low, the two chips will be selected. Okay. If the pin is high for any reason, none of the chips will be selected. Okay, and this G2 B-bar has been connected to ground forever. Right, so and by using this particular logic diagram, we shall be able to design a single 4 to 16 decoder by using two 74LS138 chips. Right, on the same lines, we shall be able to design a 5 to 32 decoder. Okay, by using 3 to 8 decoders only. But here, we cannot have only 2 3 to 8 decoders. We need to have more number of 3 to 8 decoders. It is very clear. It is understood. Okay, because we know that any one 3 to 8 decoder shall be able to generate only 8 outputs at any point of time students. Now, if at all we look for 32 outputs, then definitely we need to have 4 decoders. Right, so now here is a diagram where we have the 4 decoders. Right, now to select these 4 decoders, we need to have a selector circuitry. Right, now what should be the selector circuitry? How should it be connected? That depends upon the truth table that we are going to write. Okay, this is a general information. Now let us see how the truth table is. Okay, see here. Okay, if you can see here, okay, this enable inputs remain the same just like our 74LS138, no change with respect to that. Now, if you see the input lines, okay, you can see that two MSBs have changed. Okay, from 0 to 7, both of them happen to be 0. Okay, from 8 to 15, it is 0, 1. Okay, then from 16 to 23, it is 10. Then from 24 to 31, it is 11. Okay, so what are the values of those two MSBs? 00, 01, 10, 11. Now we can have 4 different values. If at all we want to have 4 different outputs, what should be the number of inputs we need to have? We need to have 2 inputs. So what should be the circuit that we need to have here is the question. So here we have 2 to 4 decoder. Okay, that is a circuit which will be able to generate 4 outputs by giving 2 inputs. Right? Now, just like the previous case, here ABC remains the same, that LSBs remains the same. So, we have shorted all the LSBs here. Okay, we have considered only the MSBs, and by using MSB, we are able to select the, we are able to get the output, and the outputs of these are used to select one of the 4 decoders. Okay, so when these are 2 or 0, this one will be selected. When it is 0, 1, the second 3 to 8 decoder will be selected. When it is 10, the third 3 to 8 decoder will be selected. When it is 11, the fourth 3 to 8 decoder will be selected. This is how it functions. Now, let us write the logic diagram for the same. Now, when you say 2 to 4 decoder students, by now you know that 74LS139 is the IC that has to be used as 2 to 4 decoder. We have used 74LS139 here. Okay, so you can see here MSPs are connected to the input and of the sulfur LS139. The outputs have been connected to the enable inputs of the sulfur LS138. Okay, the LSBs, the three LSBs are connected together and they are being connected to all the three inputs, all the LSBs are the inputs of select inputs of the sulfur LS138. Okay, so accordingly, when it is 00, this will be selected. You will be having output from D0 to D7. This one will be able to give the output from D8 to D15. This will be able to give the output from D9 to D23. And this will be able to give output from D24 to D31. Right? So, depending upon the input you are going to give on these input lines, one of the decoder will be selected. And accordingly, you shall be able to design a 5 to 32 decoder, right, by using 3 to 8, by using a combination of 3 to 8 decoder and 2 to 4 decoder. Dear students, once it is not necessary that we have the integrated circuit for all the applications we look for. Many times the design what we do, okay, may not be able to get us the ICs. We may not be able to procure the ICs for all the design that we do from the market. It may not happen. Okay, so during such occasions, as a design engineer, we need to see what are the components that are available with us, and we may need to do some extra engineering so that we shall be able to get what we look for. Okay, here is one such attempt to tell you, by having 3 to 8 decoder, you shall be able to generate 4 to 16 decoder, as well as you shall be able to design 5 to 32 decoder as well. Right? I hope the concept is clear to you. Okay, by using similar concept, you can design the decoder of your choice. Okay, you can design the decoder of 6 to 64. Okay, the only requirement is the number of inputs. If the number of input is n, the number of outputs will be 2 to the power of n, right? And your selector circuit will change according to the requirement, right? I will stop with this. Let us move on to the next topic.